Today, we're going to take a look at my favorite screen recording tool, talk about why it's my favorite, and why you should use it too. This video has two parts. First, I'm going to talk about why I love the tool Awesome Screenshot and Screen Recorder. And second, I'm going to show you a little bit about the features that I like and how to use them. If you're only interested in the how-to, click on the timestamp in the description below. The tool I'm talking about is the Awesome Screenshot and Screen Recorder. From here on out, I'm just going to call it the Awesome Screenshot tool because that name is way too long. There are two reasons why I like Awesome Screenshot more than some of the other tools out there. The first reason is because it's so light. You'll notice that there are other tools out there with more features. Personally, I think that those tools are a little overbloated. You have to have too much computer to be able to run them, and trying to learn them takes a lot longer because of all the features. The second reason I like Awesome Screenshot is because of the features that are available. I'm not going to walk through all the features today because they're pretty easy to use if you just play around with them for a few minutes. So I'm on one of my favorite websites. This isn't sponsored or anything, but I buy a lot of stuff off of woot.com because sometimes they have good deals. Anyway, the screenshot tool itself is actually located right up here in my extensions. You can download it using the link in the description. We're going to walk through about four or five different ways that you can use this tool to take screenshots. The first one that I'm going to show you is the visible part. This is when you want to just take a screenshot of whatever's in your browser at the time, and it's going to exclude the tabs up at the top, the address bar, it's going to exclude the extensions. It's kind of nice when you're creating a screenshot to exclude those things because it can really remove some of the noise in your image. The second way to create a screenshot is the full page. This is a really cool feature because it scrolls through the web page, it scrolls down for me and takes a picture of the entire web page, even the stuff that's not visible. This is my screenshot that I'm looking at now and I have the full page. The third option is to just take a snip of whatever area I want on the page. So I can take a snip of this here and click capture. And now I've got a screenshot there. Couple more tools that are really kind of handy. First is the visible part after delay. I'm going to jump to another web page to show you this. Sometimes when you're on a web page, you want to capture something that when you hover over it, it displays. But those can be a pain to capture because as soon as you move off, you lose whatever you're displaying, right? Well, with this tool, it has a delayed capture. So I click and now I have a timer over here on the right. I hover and give it a little bit of time. It's going to take a screenshot, and now I've captured that interaction with the hover. Makes it really nice for capturing those hover interactions. And then finally, I am able to, if I want, I can make my screen smaller, right, or my browser smaller, and I can capture my entire browser at one time by using the entire screen and app window. That makes it so that, you know, if I want to take a screenshot of something more than just what's in my browser, I can do that. Now, let's walk through some of the features that are available once you've taken your screenshot. So first, let's look at, up here on the toolbar, let's look at the crop. This is nice if I'm wanting to just take, crop out my screenshot, especially if I took that desktop picture and I want to crop out whatever it is I don't need in my screenshot. I can do that really easily, and now I just have only what I want. The second feature I use frequently is the arrows. There's more details here and additional features you can try out for yourself, but I usually just use the default. I use these a lot of times when I'm wanting to send something to somebody else and draw their attention to whatever it is we're talking about. Any of these annotations can be really easily deleted. You just click on them and delete, right? And then finally, the third feature that I actually find the most valuable when I'm creating training materials, I use this all the time. It's this step tool. So I can click on the step tool, and as I click, it's going to add individual number steps into my screenshot so I can call out step by step where things are going. Now, when I add, as I'm adding steps, I can, if I need to change the process, I can come up to my color, change my color, and then restart my sequence. And now I have a whole new step-by-step process here. I can also make these a little larger, and the tool will remember my size so that when I click on the next step, it keeps that same size so I'm consistent across the board. This has saved me tons of time. Before, I used to go in another graphic design tool and add the circle and then add the text. This saves me tons of time, and I don't have to deal with that garbage. Anyway, that's all of the screenshot tools. The last thing I'm going to show you is the screen recording tool. It's a really basic screen recorder. I can record my desktop or individual tabs, or if I really wanted to, I could record with my camera. In this case, you know, it's really simple. I'll just record my desktop really quick. When you have multiple displays, it's going to ask you which display you want to use. You'll want to check this share system audio box if you want to include the audio coming out of your speakers in your recording. Then I click share. It's going to record for a little bit. I can record whatever I might need to. Then I hit stop sharing. And here's my video. You'll notice their screen recorder is really limited on features as far as editing and cropping and cutting. Generally though, that doesn't bother me at all. Most of my edits I do outside. If you're wanting to do more editing in your screenshot or in your screen recording tool, this may not be the tool for you, but I find it to be really helpful. The last thing that I want to show you, the feature that I really like, is this generate shareable link. A lot of times when I'm taking screenshots, it's because I'm trying to communicate something to somebody really quickly. And there is a link generation on both the screenshot and screen recording. So I can generate and copy shareable links in both cases. Makes it really easy to share my content with other people. And I use that feature all the time. That is Awesome Screenshot and Screen Recorder. Thanks so much for watching my video today, and I hope you have a fantastic rest of your week. Thanks. Bye.